Hello everybody, this is Evan Abrams, and in this After Effects tutorial, we're going to make this string of lights that kind of gets twanged around by a candy cane, I guess? Now, while we're going to be making a string of lights that bounces around, the purpose of this tutorial is to teach you about the Create Nulls from Path script that comes bundled with After Effects. It's right there in the panel for you. It allows you to have access to the points. You can stick them on nulls, you can stick nulls on the points, you can get the tangent of lines. It's terrific, and hopefully it opens up a lot of possibilities for you. There are certainly many third-party scripts that do similar things, and they're wonderful, and you should check those out, but I recommend playing around with the vanilla stuff that comes with After Effects and see if it doesn't jog something for you. This tutorial is brought to you by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community for creators with more than 25,000 classes in design, business, and much, much more. A premium membership gives you unlimited access so you can join the classes and communities that are just right for you and your New Year's goals. Whether you want to fuel your curiosity, creativity, or even career, Skillshare is the perfect place to keep you learning and thriving in 2019. One teacher I really enjoy on there is Aaron Draplin. He's an amazing designer, illustrator, and has a terrific approach to ideation that I think every designer should check out. If you're ever struggling for new ideas or where to take a design, you should definitely check out his courses on that specific problem. Skillshare is also super affordable. An annual subscription is less than $10 a month. Join more than 7 million creators learning on Skillshare. The first 500 of my subscribers to use the link in the description, skl.sh/ecabrams8, that's EC Abrams and the number 8, will get a 2-month free trial. We're here in After Effects. Let's get it going by making a new composition. Let's call this the example comp. None of these settings are important. They're not useful in any way. We might make use of the frame rate for something later, but we'll see how it goes. So I'm going to start by just drawing a path out there. I'm going to turn on the proportional grid and grab my pen tool here. And I'm just going to draw a path. I'm going to click over here. Click generally in the center, nice, and then click outside. And wouldn't you know it, I've gone ahead and I've made that wire that we're going to hang bulbs on. Let me just drag this down a little bit. Probably going to sag down around there. And if we wanted to animate this path, if we want to animate the path doing something, we would have to twirl in here, twirl into the contents, twirl into shape one, twirl into the path. There's the path, and we'll set some keyframes, and we just have to set a keyframe for each kind of position that we want the path to be in. So maybe it would be there, and then it would be up like this, and then it would be back down, and we could totally do that. That's a way you could animate this path around. However, another way we could do it is by sticking nulls on these points, or more accurately, sticking these points on some nulls and moving those nulls around. And so we could get access to things like inertia or speed from the position value of those nulls rather than being locked into just whatever path data we're making. So how do we do that? Well, we're going to go window and go down here to create nulls from path. And this should be part of After Effects. If it's not there, then you may just be using an older version of After Effects. This has been with After Effects for a while. I'm using CC 2019, but yours may have it. Depends on when you updated last. But I've got my path selected. I'm twirled all the way in, and I've selected that path. I'm as far down as we can go. I've selected the path. And I could click, for example, nulls follow points. So if I click on that, it's going to make a bunch of nulls for me, and the nulls follow the points, which means I can't grab one of these nulls and move them around, but if I grab the path and I grab that point and I move it around, then the null follows the points, just like it says. It's that easy. If you twirl in here, I'm hitting EE to call this stuff up. You can see that After Effects has a lot of language now to describe where the points are. So this is saying, hey, position of this null, this is how you find it. This is how you find the position of that point, which is pretty great. However, what we want are nulls that will push these points around. So I'm going to say, with that path selected, points follow nulls. All right. So now I've got these three different nulls, and I can grab them and move them around, and the points move. And they're all independent of each other, so I can grab these and move them around and do whatever I'd like, and they'll all move independently of each other. So if I want to animate this path here, if I want to animate it, you know, going from, let's say it'll start here, I'll just move ahead a few frames, call up its position by hitting P, set a keyframe for that. Let's go ahead a whole second, drag it down like here, and then maybe it'll sproing back up to here. And then maybe it'll sproing back down like so. And I'm just setting positional keyframes, moving this thing along, kind of like here. And And now you can see we've got this animating along. Boing, boing, going, going. That's very bad. We're going to have to ease these, go into the graph editor. I'm going to grab the handle here. We're looking at a speed graph still, but we could look at a value graph. But boing, oing, 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 oing. Yeah, that's perfectly fine. And now we've got this thing being animated. Now, one thing we can't change about this is the handles on this. And by handles, I mean the Bezier curve here. It's currently locked at nothing. If I go to my Convert Vertex tool, I can't even click on the points anymore because it's taken that option away from me. All you have to do to unlock that feature is just hit this here, take the expression off, and then we can drag out the handles as we like. Now what happens is these handles are going to be locked in this orientation and this position. I think there are other third-party scripts that'll give you access to these, but what that means is once we turn this back on, you'll notice that now it's boing, wah, 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 kind of like that. So, ooh, maybe that was a bit too extreme. Let me just touch that up a little bit. Maybe here and maybe here. Maybe that feels better. Let's check that out. Boing, yoing, 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 yoing. Good. Now, these nulls would also allow you to, if you don't want to keyframe all of these things, to use an inertial bounce expression. Many of those are available online. Google them up. And you just apply them onto the position. So you could have this bounce happening without much to do at all. But what if we want to put some light bulbs on here? We want to stick some light bulbs on this path. Let's do that next. Well, we would grab that path again. And even though we've got this big nasty expression on it, a whole bunch of stuff going on, not going to dive into that, not going to touch it, very terrifying. Just select the path and click here, trace path. Now, what does that do? What does trace path do? Well, by default, it's set a couple of keyframes here on something called progress, and it just keeps looping around, keeps tracing that path. This is a null that's going to go along the path from 0% to 100%, just like if you were using a trim paths or something like that. And it's really just tracing the path, just going along the path, whatever shape that path happens to be. So even if it gets stretched or distorted or changed, it's still hanging out at what it perceives as, you know, 73%. So I'm going to remove those keyframes and let's just set this at 90. It's going to hang out always at 90% of the path. I'm going to select that layer and duplicate it, hitting UU to bring up all the information. And let's see, let's go to 70. This one can hang out here at 70. And duplicate, make another one, and maybe at 50. It can hang out at 50. And how about one at 30? There we go, that one's at 30. And I'll duplicate again, and let's set this one at 10. Now, it's also important to notice that not only is the position, it's getting stuck on the line, its rotation is matching the tangent of the line. So it's always going to be on the tangent of that line. Very cool stuff, very useful stuff. But now we've got four placeholders where we could string up some lights. So I'll just grab this light bulb that I made earlier. Cool light bulb, and I'll just grab its parent whip here, hold down shift, and stick it over there, and duplicate, and stick another one, duplicate, and stick that third one, duplicate, stick the fourth one, duplicating, and sticking. You're just holding down shift when you parent, and then it sticks it right onto where you want it to go. So now, if you want these bulbs to kind of splay out, like maybe their connections with the line are very hard, then they would splay out like so, just boom. And as you can see, they're just moving along, stuck to the path. They can't go anywhere because these nulls are stuck to the path and they can't go anywhere. So it's all conforming just based on those earlier keyframes we made. That's pretty good stuff, I think. Now, what if we want the bulbs to appear to be heavy? What if you have something attached to a line and it needs to hang from the line? Well, we would need the rotation to go back a little bit. So let's grab, say, this one out here, this one out here on the edge. Let's work with it. I'm going to call up its rotation, and we know that it's stuck to this null. So let's put them next to each other. They're a pair. What a pair. What a couple characters. We've got the rotation here and the rotation of the bulb. I'm going to hold down Alt, click on that rotation, and just type in R equals that rotation. And I'm going to hit a semicolon to end that variable. We've created variable R that equals the rotation of the thing it's parented to. And if I want this to counter the rotation, I want it to rotate back the same amount that it's rotated clockwise, anti-clockwise, whatever. I just want it to rotate back to nothing. So I would need to go R times negative 1. That would get me back where I want to go. So not positive 1, negative 1. And as you can see, that rotates it back in line. That's right where I would want it to hang out. So as this rotation is increasing, the rotation of the child is decreasing by the same amount, leaving it constantly hanging out like this. Now, that doesn't give me kind of the wobble I want. To achieve that, I use something called value at time. So right now I'm looking at this comp, and inside this comp I'm looking at this layer, and inside that layer I'm looking into its transform, and then the transform rotation. And now even more specifically, I want to know about that rotation's value at time and a different time than the time we're at now. By default, the time is time, T-I-M-E. If you want to learn more about the time expression, then check it out on this channel. We have a video all about that. But I'm going to say, tell me the value at time, and then in these parentheses, which time specifically? Well, the time that it was, I'm going to say like 0.1 second ago. Tell me about that time. So now it's going to tell me an older time. It's going to be referencing a different time, which makes it kind of jangle around a little bit, which is pretty fun. That's a fun jangly light. I like that. So now I'm just going to duplicate this. You can just copy it and you just paste it onto the rotation of these others. So just go paste, 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 pasting it on there. Now, importantly, you need to update this. You know, this one is looking at path 1, 1.1. However, you need to get these going to the correct nulls. So let's see, it's looking at the one without anything on it. Let's see, this one would be parented to this guy here with the 2 on it. So I'm just going to go here. I'm going to go space 2, and that means this one is probably space 3, I'm going to imagine. And then this one here, I'm just assuming is 4, which would make this one 5. Does that make sense? I don't know. We're going to find out when this goes boing. Hey, pretty good, right? And now these bulbs are jangling around on the string. And all of this is derived from that earlier motion, right? All of this is possible because we're able to set up little systems to make this work for us. We're animating the path using some nulls. We're then using that path to drive the tangent, the rotation of these other nulls. And then we're getting the rotation of the bulbs to play off of that rotation. So you can see how all these little things kind of link together. And all of that is possible because of the create nulls from path script. So that's it. That is a string of lights and a basic introduction to the create nulls from path script. Hopefully you've enjoyed this. Hopefully it's made sense. If you got confused anywhere, please let me know in the comments and I'll try to get you through. If you'd like to get your hands on this little example that we just made, head on over to evanabrams.com. Links in the description, links in the cards. If you enjoy learning about After Effects, motion design, visual effects, subscribe to this channel. That's pretty much all we do around here. If you have a question about After Effects in general, if you want to request a tutorial, hit me up on Twitter at ECAbrams on there. Get involved on the Facebook page. Links to all that in the description. And if you subscribe, I will see you next time. Thanks again for watching and have a great day. This tutorial is brought to you by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community for creators with more than 25,000 classes in design, business, and much, much more. A premium membership gives you unlimited access so you can join the classes and communities that are just right for you and your New Year's goals. Whether you want to fuel your curiosity, creativity, or even career, Skillshare is the perfect place to keep you learning and thriving in 2019. One teacher I really enjoy on there is Aaron Draplin. He's an amazing designer, illustrator, and has has a terrific approach to ideation that I think every designer should check out. If you're ever struggling for new ideas or where to take a design, you should definitely check out his courses on that specific problem. Skillshare is also super affordable. An annual subscription is less than $10 a month. Join more than 7 million creators learning on Skillshare. The first 500 of my subscribers to use the link in the description, skl.sh/ecabrams8, that's ecabrams and the number 8, will get a 2-month free trial.